Hi, this is Glenda. Yesterday I was quite excited that I had had more than 1,000 video views because I only had 21 subscribers, and so I found that a nice milestone to be pleased about. Today, thanks to Glenda at Wicked Glen 1, the number of subscribers has gone up by 60. It's just absolutely phenomenal. I am quite chuffed, to say the least, and I'm hoping I can live up to the lovely plug that she's given me. I have made a project from the flower that I did yesterday, which I'm just checking is in camera. So that's one. I've still got another one to do something with. So I was actually watching Glenda's video on her birdcage and felt like making a birdcage, but mine's going to be flat and go on a card. So so many people make all these lovely birdcages, and yeah, mine, everything ends up flat and on a card. So I've just got a piece of cardstock, whatever size you want, and I've already cut a circle, which you can do with a die cutter, a circle maker, or simply a knife, whatever you've got to get your circle. And I've marked off the halfway mark, and I'm just going to cut a little roof, and then I'm going to use the bit I cut off as the guide for the other corner, which works for anything where you want to put matching corners, or at least so I'm told. And I'm just going to get my Cuddlebug folder. I may have put my circle up a bit high. Anyway, never done this before. It's all an experiment. I'm just going to run the roof part through the embossing folder. Okay, so I'm really feeling that this circle's up too high, and I'm going to start again. Okay, so since this is all an experiment, I will probably be stopping this frequently as I go to get bits and pieces and do bits and pieces. And cut that nice and even. What's half of 9.5? So if this one's too high, so if we bring the circle down there. I think I may have actually said bird cage before when I meant birdhouse, I'm not sure. Anyway, clearly it's not a cage. Okay, I think that looks better. Back to the Cuddlebug folder. Okay, so I'm going to add some pearls. I'm just not sure what or where. Maybe some lace. Okay, we'll see how we go. This lace was actually sent to me as a bonus from Chris at a Scrap and Idea when I ordered some stuff off her the other day. I've no idea how this is going to turn out. It may or may not even work. But I have been wanting to do a birdhouse. I think both these pearls were from a treasure's nest. Cut my little birds out of the Stampin' Up! Bird Punch. So naturally I have these little leaves. left over. Background card, and I will be lining it when I've finished. It's only thin because I got the cardstock for free. It's almost a bit big. Okay, so these are my two little birds. Tiny bit of pink. Now that they'll just go with the pink. They're going to be a bit humongous, aren't they? So snip the feathers as close into the center as you can to minimize feather spread. Could emboss the little birds. So, hoping this works. I've done it before and it has worked. This is a tip from Fiona at Jennings 644, where you take a curling iron for hair and curl your feathers. Ideally, I'd like a much finer curling iron for this. I don't know if you can get them. I've had this one forever. I think it's all about getting that center quill around the iron, because that's the part that's going to curl. Okay, I think what I will do is add some eyes to my birds, mount this on the card, add some more trim, and come back. Okay, so I've been fiddling. I haven't stuck the birds down yet. I think that's about where they're going to go. I've added a dark blue circle so it doesn't look like they're on a movie set that has no substance to the building. Added some bling around the edges. Put some glitter glue in the middle to cover up all my really bad gluing. I think that's all I did off camera. Oh, and of course, the card I was going to put it on was way too small, so I have put it on a 5x7. So I just thought I'd try and make some little flowers to go on it. So I've got the Boho Blossom Punch, which I've barely used, which of course is another stampener. It seemed like something I had to have because everybody seemed to keep using it, but then I suppose I watch a lot of Stampin' Up! Videos because A lot of those are the people who make, well, not the videos as much as the blogs. Oh, a lot of the videos too, I suppose. Single flowers, I think. Okay, so I'll get some pearls and add those and come back again. Okay, I'm just going to add a bling swirl, and this was a little trick I saw from Christina at Card Making Magic. Just peel off. This is a leftover bit that I've cut all sorts of bits off. Peel off part of your backing and attach, like, lie it down where you want it. And then as you pull off the rest, it should more or less fall into place. And it is definitely easier than trying to peel it all off at once. Get it to stick down. Now, I'm not sure where I had the birds because I moved them. I'm not putting them in the entrance because any time I've ever had one of these birdhouses in the garden, the birds don't use it. What they do like in our garden is the free food on the feeder. The trouble with my feathers are that they cover up everything. No decision's going to be quite right here. Okay, now it's done. I would not say this card's one of my finest moments. I could put it down to lack of sleep because my grandchildren had a sleepover and I don't know, not everything works. But it's loaded with heaps of bling, some of which is expensive, and somebody will get it. I mean, a little girl would love it. It may look better when this glitter glue is dry and it's not so dark. I have trimmed the feathers, they were just too much. I should never have put them on when they're so big, but they were so pretty. So anyway, the technique for doing a birdhouse is there, and if you watched right through, I'm sorry, it didn't turn out better. So that's today's not-so-masterpiece. thanks for watching.